In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the show Vikings and how it went from being one of the best series on television to barely even watchable. First, let's start with season 1. We're introduced to our main character, Ragnar Lothbrok, and his wife, Lagerfar. Next, we meet Ragnar's son, Bjorn, his daughter, Gida, and his brother, Rollo. Now, you see, Ragnar wants to sail west, but no one has ever done that before, and the Earl, the guy in charge, he doesn't like the sound of that idea.
I will not risk my ships on such a deluded fantasy. Now that's the end of the matter.
So what does Ragnar do? Well, he goes to see his friend Floki, who builds him a boat, and then Ragnar gathers a crew and they head west across the open sea, eventually arriving in Northumbria, England, raiding, raping and murdering their way through, stealing all the treasures and even the priests to sell into slavery. However, when they arrive home, the Earl takes all of their treasure for disobeying him, but then allows Ragnar and his crew to take one item each for their troubles. So Ragnar chooses a priest named Athelstan. Later on, Ragnar goes back to see the Earl to ask if he can sail west again.
On one condition. A warrior I trust goes with you. Knut, you will not regret this.
So they set sail and arrive in England again. More treasure, more murder. But then, the Earl's man Canute tries to rape Ragnar's wife Lagerfar, a move which cost him his life. And when they get home and the Earl finds out, he and his men go to kill the Lothbrok family, but they all escape. And then Ragnar sends Floki to challenge the Earl to personal combat on his behalf.
That's right, you and me, right now, we're having it out, let's go!
So they fight, and it ends with Ragnar killing Earl Haraldson and becoming the new Earl. Earl Ragnar decides to sail to England again, but this time King Ayla and his men are ready. At least they think they're ready, but they weren't. They all die, and afterwards, Ragnar goes to see the king to tell him you'll have to pay £2,000 of gold and silver to get us to leave, to which the king agrees. But when time comes to hand over payment, the boxes are empty and the king's men are sent in. And once again, they all die, so now the king doesn't have any other choice but to pay.
Thanks for the money, stupid fuck.
Ragnar meets with King Horik of Denmark, and he sends Ragnar to settle a land dispute with Jarl Borg. He claims the land belongs to him, but is willing to negotiate. So Ragnar sends Floki back to the king to find out if he wants to negotiate. And while they wait, Jarl Borg suggests Ragnar explores his lands, but also asks Ragnar to leave one of his men behind with him for insurance. So Ragnar picks Rollo and then goes to explore the lands. He comes across a woman named Aslog, and her and Ragnar take a shine into one another. Meanwhile, back home, a deadly sickness spreads throughout Kattegat, killing Ragnar's daughter Gida. Also, King Horik doesn't want to negotiate, so now it's war. But Jarl Borg has convinced Rollo to stand with him.
I will fight with you against my brother.
Rollo fights alongside Jarl Borg and even kills Ragnar's friend, but in the end can't bring himself to kill his own brother, so he surrenders. And then Ragnar gives a great speech that convinces King Horik and Jarl Borg to put aside their differences and all sail west together. But first, Ragnar goes home to see his family when a pregnant Aslog arrives, which really complicates things for Lagerfar, so she leaves and Bjorn decides to go with her.
Okay, bye!
Ragnar and Aslog have been busy pumping out sons. We've got Uber, Vixak and Sigurd. Now the time has finally come to sail west again, and Ragnar asks Athelstan to join him. Jarl Borg and King Horik are also coming until the king changes his mind. He doesn't want Jarl Borg to come, and he makes Ragnar break the news to him, which he doesn't take well. So when they set sail, Jarl Borg and his men invade and conquer Kattegat, forcing Ragnar's family into the cold and leaving Rollo to look after them. But when Ragnar finds out what Jarl Borg did, he rushes home while Athelstan stays in England. Lagerfar heard what happened as well and brings an army. Also, Bjorn.
I always knew in my heart that I would see you again.
So Jarl Borg is defeated and Ragnar decides he deserves to be blood-eagled, which is basically when your back is sliced open with a knife, then your ribs are chopped away from your spine and your lungs are pulled out and laid on your shoulders to look like the folded wings of an eagle, and you stay like that until you die.
Oh, that's nasty.
The army Lagerfar brought with her belonged to her new husband, El Sigvard. He's a cunt, but he gets what he deserves, and now Lagerfer's the L, and she wants to travel west with Ragnar again. Also, Bjorn falls in love, and Arslog gives birth to Ragnar's fifth and final son, Ivar, who's born with legs like Ricky Berwick.
Hi.
Back in England, Æthelstan is captured and crucified until King Egbert of Wessex, showing mercy, spares his life. He also creates an alliance between himself and King Æla by marrying his son to King Æla's daughter. So now, the next time the Vikings attack, they've got each other's backs. Two armies are better than one. And it works a treat. The Vikings are defeated and Rollo is trampled by horses, then captured. So King Egbert offers the Vikings Rollo back and 5,000 acres of land for farming if they agree to stop raiding.
I accept the offer.
As do I.
Ragnar gives Æthelstan the choice to stay in England with his people or to come home with him. And in the end, Æthelstan chooses Kattegat. Also, King Horik plans to kill Ragnar but ends up getting killed himself, and now Ragnar's the king.
When the ice finally breaks, we will go back to Wessex and claim the land that King Egbert promised us.
When the Vikings arrive in Wessex, King Egbert tells them if they want the land he promised, they have to fight for Princess Quenfrith of Mercia, who's been usurped by her uncle and brother. So they kill the uncle, making the brother surrender to later be poisoned anyway by his own sister.
To the Queen of Mercia.
To the Queen.
Æthelstan, Lagerfer, and the Viking settlers farm the land given by King Egbert. He also gives Lagerfer a plough. And then he gives Lagerfer a plough. Even Æthelstan gets some. Problem is, he's fucking Egbert's son's wife. So the Vikings head home. And on the journey back, Æthelstan tells Ragnar about Paris. And so he decides that's where they're going to be raiding next. And then Lagerfer finds out Kalf, the guy she trusted to look after her earldom while she was away, has made himself earl and claimed her land. So she confronts him. But instead of fighting, she works with him to conquer Paris. However, Lagerfer makes Kalf a promise.
One day, I will kill you.
Judith, who's Egbert's son's wife, tells him she cheated on him. So he gets her ear cut off for being a hoe, and then he takes his men and goes and slaughters all of the Viking settlers.
And not just the men, but the women, and the children too.
King Egbert is proud of his son for ridding the pagans from his land. Bjorn falls in love again, this time with Torvi, who was Jarlborg's wife and is now married to Erlander, son of King Horik. Æthelstan sees some light and becomes a Christian again. He even throws away his arm ring, which really pisses off Floki, so he kills him, and that breaks Ragnar. Anyway, to Paris. The Vikings invade and get defeated, so they attack again and get defeated again. Regardless, the cowardly French Emperor offers £5,760 of gold and silver for Ragnar and his men to leave. Ragnar accepts the offer. Unfortunately though, he becomes ill and dies, so Bjorn convinces the French to give Ragnar a funeral. But it was all a ruse. Ragnar Trojan horsed himself.
I win.
This time, Ragnar's men successfully raid Paris, and then head back home. But Rollo and half of the Vikings stay behind, as the others are planning to come back and raid again. So the cowardly French Emperor offers Rollo land, title, riches, and his daughter's hand in marriage, and all Rollo has to do is defend Paris from his brother, to which he agrees.
Oh no, not again.
Rollo gets a visit from his friend, who warns him the other Vikings aren't happy and don't want to fight for the French. So what does Rollo do? Well, he gets a group of soldiers together and kills all the Vikings. Even his mate gets it. Rollo and Princess Gisla are married, much to her disgust. But after he learns the language and professes his love for her, she comes round to the idea. Ragnar punishes Floki for what he did to Æthelstan until later on, when Floki's daughter dies and Ragnar shows him mercy by freeing and forgiving him. Lagerfer keeps her promise to Kalf and kills him, regaining her earldom. And Erlander wants Torvi to kill Bjorn, but she kills him instead. Queen Quenfrith has had a son that she claims Ragnar is the father to. Also, she's been overthrown again. but this time the overthrower gives the crown to Egbert, making him the king of Wessex and Mercia. And when Quenfrith finds out, she tries to kill Egbert, but he's saved by Judith, who stabs and kills Quenfrith because she's been fucking her father-in-law.
Whore.
And so enters King Harold Finehair, who brings the boats and the men to help Ragnar raid Paris, but Rollo defeats them.
When everyone wanted you dead, I kept you alive! And this is how you repay my love!
So they fight again, and once again Rollo defeats them and finally gets the fame and attention he's always wanted.
Oh, good for you!
Whereas Ragnar, he never recovers from the defeat, so he runs away and hides, just like Jake Skywalker did. And then 10 years later, he comes back.
Who wants to be king?
Ragnar is going back to England to get his revenge, and he asks his sons to join him, but they say no. Bjorn found a map in Paris of the Mediterranean Sea, and he gets Floki to build him boats to travel there. So when Ragnar goes and asks Floki to come with him, he also says no, as he's already agreed to go with Bjorn. Next, Ragnar asks Lagertha, but she says no as well. She's too busy rug munching. With nowhere left to turn, Ragnar tries to kill himself, but fails. So he goes home and asks Ivar to come with him, and Ivar says yes. Which is funny, because Ragnar never wanted Ivar, and now Ivar's the only one who wants Ragnar.
That's like poetry, sort of, they rhyme.
Bjorn sets sail for the Mediterranean, but has to go through France to get there. So he asks Rollo for safe passage, and Rollo says only if he's allowed to come with them. Bjorn accepts, and they explore new lands together. Meanwhile, Lagertha overthrows Arslog, killing her, making Lagertha the new queen of Kattegat. Hollywood should take notes. This is how you do a strong, independent woman. But instead, we get
Rey Skywalker.
So they arrive in Wessex, and Ragnar asks Egbert to kill him, but Egbert doesn't want to. So Ragnar asks he hand him over to King Ayla, who happily kills Ragnar.
Why?
And this is the beginning of the downfall of Vikings. The show should have died with Ragnar, and if you stopped watching it here, you would have watched one hell of a show. Maybe even one of the best. Unfortunately, there's 2 more seasons and 40 more episodes, so let's keep going. Egbert sends Ivar home, and when he finds out what happened to his mum, he tries to kill Lagertha, but is stopped by Bjorn, who's raised a great heathen army to take revenge on the kings of England. First, it's Ayla, who's defeated, then blood-eagled, and when word spreads of what happened, Egbert renounces the crown to his son and sends him and his family away to safety, while he stays behind, and when the Vikings arrive, Egbert offers them land for farming, and in return, Egbert is allowed to kill himself, which is definitely better than being blood-eagled.
Well, no shit.
While celebrating their victory, Bjorn announces he's going back to finish exploring the Mediterranean Sea, and King Harald's brother wants to go with him. Also, Ivar kills Sigurd, and I can't help but think what a pointless death for one of the sons of Ragnar. Wasted potential. Like, why fuck about doing the character setup of Sigurd Snake in the Eye if you're just gonna kill him? Anyway, back in Kattegat, they're being attacked, until Lagertha fucks up the attackers and then tortures the guy to find out who sent him.
I was paid by King Harald Finehair.
King Harald goes to Kattegat and is surprised to see Lagertha alive. He's even more surprised when she tells him she knows and then imprisons him. But King Harald escapes, then kidnaps Lagertha's lesbian lover, who for some reason develops Stockholm syndrome and agrees to marry him. Back in England, continuing to raid, the great Viking army claim the town of York. So King Æthelwulf and his men show up to reclaim York, but instead get royally fucked up, forcing them to retreat. So Uber and Vixxer go to them offering peace, but the English ain't interested in peace, so they rough them up and send them back. Surely they would have just killed Uber and Vixxer, but I guess not. Ivar makes himself leader of the army, and Uber doesn't like that, so he decides to leave with Vixxer. But Vixxer decides to stay with Ivar, and King Æthelwulf and his men try to reclaim York again, and again get fucked up and retreat. King Æthelwulf then gets stung by a bee, has an allergic reaction and dies, which is by far the worst character death I've ever seen. I thought maybe the real King Æthelwulf died this way, but no, He died of old age, so what the fucking fuck? I get the writer wanted Alfred to be king, but you could have killed Æthelwulf in either of the battles for York, which would have been so much more impactful than a fucking bee. Back with Ivar, he still wants revenge on Lagertha, so he allies himself with King Harald. Uber agrees to fight with Lagertha, and Bjorn and Halfdan explore the Mediterranean and then head home.
Well, it seems I have returned just in time.
The two armies fight, and it ends with Ivar and Harald being defeated, so they ask Rollo for help, and he helps by supplying them with French soldiers. So they fight again, King Harald kills his brother for fighting against him with Bjorn, Uber goes to kill Vitsuk but stops himself at the last second, and Lagertha kills her ex for marrying King Harald. Then Ivar sends in the French, and they defeat Lagertha's army, leaving the survivors to... Ivar and King Harald claim Kattegat, and Ivar makes himself king. But that doesn't make sense. Since he was introduced, all King Harald has gone on about is becoming king of all Norway. That's why he sent people to kill Lagertha when she was queen. So why the fuck would he give up the throne of Kattegat to Ivar?
I don't know.
Rollo finds Lagertha, Bjorn, Uber and Torvi, and then he tells Bjorn...
I am your father.
Which actually does make sense. Throughout the whole series, Rollo's referred to as a bear, and when Ragnar tells Bjorn how he won Lagertha's hand in marriage, he says,
I went to confess my love to her, but I was set upon by a bear.
So all the times Rollo betrayed Ragnar don't seem as bad now we know Ragnar betrayed Rollo first, by stealing his woman who was pregnant with his son. However, I would have much preferred if the revelation of Bjorn being Rollo's son was revealed when Ragnar was still alive. That could have been a really cool story arc. Anyway, Rollo offers them all to come with him to Paris, but they decline and choose to take their chances in England. After all, Egbert did sign them over land.
My grandfather had no authority to grant you any land. He had already relinquished the throne to my father, who was crowned here a few days before you arrived.
King Alfred offers protection and promises land, as long as they help defend England against other invading Vikings, to which they agree. Back in Kattegat, Ivar falls in love, and so does Vitsuk. Oh, and I completely forgot about this little cunt. You remember Queen Quentfrith had a son she claimed belonged to Ragnar? Well, when Ragnar went to Wessex to die, he met the boy Magnus and told him he can't be his father, he never fucked his mother. And when Egbert heard this, he banished Magnus from his kingdom. Well, now he's back, and he's still claiming to be a son of Ragnar.
I am sorry. I just don't believe your story.
King Harald attacks England in what can only be described as a glorious battle, but with the help of Uber, King Alfred's men defeat King Harald's, forcing him to retreat. And as promised, King Alfred grants Uber the land of East Anglia. Bjorn falls in love again, Uber falls in love with Torvi, Ivar's girlfriend is pregnant, and Judith gets breast cancer and dies. Bjorn wants to take Kattegat back from Ivar, so he goes to York and makes a deal with King Harald.
I had an arrangement with Ivar that after his death, I would be king of Kattegat.
Well, then we will make the same arrangement.
But why would King Harald take that deal? He's the one with the ships, he's the one with the army, while Bjorn has nothing. Nevertheless, Harald accepts the deal. Ivar and Vitsuk haven't been getting on, so Ivar sends Vitsuk away to get him reinforcements. And while he's away, Ivar burns Vitsuk's girlfriend to death. Vitsuk, who has no idea, planned to betray Ivar anyway, and convinces King Olaf and his men to fight against Ivar. On the way to Kattegat, Bjorn's forces bump into Vitsuk's, and they agree to work together. Ivar's girlfriend gives birth, and his son is also a cripple, so Ivar leaves him for dead, just like Ragnar did to him.
Ironic.
Uber decides it's time to leave England and head home. Meanwhile, Bjorn attempts to breach Ivar's defences but fails, and walks away defeated. Also, Magnus dies.
Yes! Hell yeah! Hey, come on, baby! Come on! Yes! Come on!
That night, Ivar's girlfriend goes to Bjorn and tells him there's a secret passageway into Kattegat that she'll open for them in the morning. So they defeat Ivar's men and he runs away, but before he does, he kills his missus for betraying him. And Bjorn is made the new king of Kattegat. Now you might be wondering, what happened to Floki? Well, the less said about this story arc the better, so I'm going to keep this short and sweet. Floki's missus dies and he becomes a wanderer, going wherever the gods take him, ending up in Iceland. Believing it's the land of the gods, Floki goes back to Kattegat, grabs a bunch of people and starts a settlement back in Iceland. But it all goes wrong and turns into chaos. So Floki walks away and comes across a cave. He explores it, then dies when the cave collapses on top of him. He's definitely dead. There's no way he survived. 100% dead.
Oh, Floki.
Bjorn is shown to be a merciful king. He decides to banish Ivar's men rather than killing them. Lagertha is done with fighting. She just wants to be a farmer, so she gives up the sword and buries it. Now this scene is really dragged out. They treat it like it's this big thing. But then she digs up her sword only two episodes later.
Waste of our time! Fucking waste of our time!
King Harald was stabbed, saving Bjorn when they overthrew Ivar, and while he was recovering from being stabbed, King Olaf took his throne and then imprisoned him. And now Harald asks for Bjorn's help, so Bjorn goes to save him, but King Olaf offers democracy instead of war.
I love democracy.
All the kings and the earls get together and vote for a king of kings. Harald wins the election and finally gets what he's always wanted, being crowned king of all Norway. Back in Kattegat, Vitsak has become a drunk because he's seeing the Freddy Krueger remains of his girlfriend everywhere he goes. The ghost wants revenge and makes Vitsak promise on his arm ring to kill Ivar. Lagertha fights the guy Bjorn banished, ending with her killing him, but not before he mortally wounds her. Now all Lagertha wants is to see Bjorn one last time, so she heads to Kattegat and gets stabbed to death by a hallucinating Vitsak who thought it was Ivar.
You're a donut! You're so stupid! You're so stupid! You're stupid!
What a shit death for a great character. But that's not the worst part. Oh no. The fact they squandered the perfect opportunity to bring Ragnar back by having him welcome Lagertha into Valhalla. Instead, they gave us Sand Ragnar.
What the hell is even that?
You remember I said Ivar ran away? Well, he ran all the way to Russia. While in Russia, Ivar meets Prince Oleg, who conveniently wants to invade and conquer Kattegat. There's a bunch of other shit that happens in Russia, like Ivar falling in love with Oleg's wife, who looks exactly like his wife that he murdered. But nothing really comes from that story arc, so fuck it. The Russians head to Norway. Meanwhile, back in Kattegat, Bjorn isn't happy with Vitsak.
You murdered my mother!
I thought that you...
Bjorn decides to burn Vitsak alive and then changes his mind and banishes him instead. And then Vitsak joins back up with Ivar. You know, the same person he's hated for a whole season for burning his girlfriend alive?
What the fuck is this?
Bjorn is stabbed by Ivar during the invasion of the Russians and his forces are defeated. Now I find it really hard to believe that Ivar hobbled through a battlefield straight up to Bjorn without getting cut down himself. But whatever. Bjorn is severely injured yet still alive, so he rides back into battle, gets shot with arrows, and then raises his sword into the air, which is enough to make the superstitious Russians run away. Bjorn then breathes his last breath and dies, and once again we miss out on the perfect opportunity to bring Ragnar back. Instead, Bjorn and his horse have been taxidermied. King Harald takes over from Bjorn as King of Kattegat, but soon realises he doesn't actually want to be king, even though that's all he ever fucking wanted. King Olaf dies, Prince Oleg dies, Bjorn's wife kills herself, Ivar and Vitsak leave Russia and go back to Kattegat, then Ivar, Vitsak and Harald take an army to Wessex for the final showdown. Harold gets stabbed, and as he's dying, his brother appears and sings him into Valhalla, which is a fantastic scene. But what? You can do it for Halfdan, but not for Ragnar? Just fuck off.
Fuck off doesn't mean go away. Fuck off means fuck off.
Vitsuk says to Ivar his eyes are blue, and that apparently means Ivar's in grave danger. However, he still goes to battle. Ivar then tells Vitsuk to stop fighting and go, but he doesn't. He just sits down and watches Ivar swing his sword around like a dickhead. I mean, what is that? We've seen Ivar kill so many people. Why is he doing this? Even King Alfred's watching like, bro, what the fuck are you doing? Then Ivar gets stabbed multiple times and dies. Now, when Vitsuk joined back up with Ivar, he said,
since it's my fate to kill you, it makes sense for me to stay with you, I suppose.
Which is what I thought Vitsuk was gonna do. But he didn't. He just laid on the floor and watched somebody else kill Ivar. Then Vitsuk renounces the gods and becomes a Christian without any explanation. It's clear the writers had no idea what to do with him. He was more of a wasted character than fucking Sigurd. Oh yeah, and lastly, Uber went searching for the Golden Lands, but we know it is North America. Uber then meets some Indians who take him to Floki. And of course Floki doesn't tell us how he escaped from the cave. Well, fuck me, that's the end of Vikings. There's one word that sums up how I feel.
Disappointed! Smoke weed every day.